Welcome back. Let's start coding. Before I jump into the server part and the web client part, it's a good idea to first look at how the FNC mapping component works at all before building the more complex server way of doing things. I got to be honest with that. You can't build the XData server if you're not feeling comfortable with the components that are available in FNC Maps. I'm just being honest here. So we create a new VCL application, and the parts that we're going to use are the FNC directions component, and we're going to use the FNC maps component. The map component you already saw is the one inside of the web client. The web client one uses not Google, which is the default setting. We can flip over to other services. So for example, on the web client, we picked Leaflet, and we immediately get the interactive map. So the service flipping is the only thing we need to do on the web client in order to initialize it. We can do that at design time, and we're ready to go. There's really not much there. So the map is easy peasy. We can add markers to the map. That's the property that we're going to use. And we can add polylines. The polyline is the line that we draw in order to show the driving that we have to do. The FNC directions component is a little bit more interesting. There, we need to pick a service too. So that is one of the big advantages of FNC maps. You can pick different services for different tasks. You can show on a leaflet map, which is free. You can show a direction that has been generated with TomTom, for example, because you think that TomTom is the service that is advantageous to the routing needs that you have. For example, truck drivers might pick TomTom because they have special logistics routing included in their package. You can still use the map that you prefer. For example, some people might prefer an Apple map design and still prefer the routing that TomTom provides, for example. That's possible too. And the way why that's possible is that we simply draw the coordinates on the map and set markers on the map, and the driving instructions in this case, not only in this case, the driving instructions are just a list of objects that contain certain properties, the duration, the distance, and the instructions, and the set of coordinates for that specific step. All this can also be found in the actual component. If you go to the component service, you can pick between Google and other services. Google is the one that I'm going to pick. We have then to set the API key. It's required. Google requires us to use an API key that we request from Google. The directions requests give us a little bit of insight how the result is going to look like. So if we click here to create a new request, we see that each request has items and each item has steps. And that's exactly what we're going to use. We're going to look into the steps, and each step, if we click here, has coordinates, distance, duration, a start location, and an end location, and instructions. Perfect, isn't it? So this is the data structure that we need to send from the server to the client, and that is not possible to be retrieved because this component here, the FNC directions component, cannot be used inside of TMS Web Core. That's the restrictions we want to overcome with this example. On the flip side, you're getting a great example how to build your own objects that you transfer in a web service, fill it with information retrieved from somewhere else, and also how to deal with asynchronous processes. And that's what I've not been telling you in the introduction, why this is actually a complex problem and not as trivial as it might seem at first. So here's the story. We have now the opportunity to either start building the user interface of the web application or to build the web server first. And I truly believe that every application project should build the model first. If you don't have a proper model, if your model isn't sound, the whole application won't work in the end, because in the end you'll realize you're missing something that you need if you don't have the model worked out correctly. Obviously, you have requirements which make you build your model, and then you go from there to build your services in this case, as you want to present the data in a web service, and then you start building your user interface to present the data from your data model or to request data from your data model. I have seen many, many other solutions where people start drawing the user interface. That's fine. Drawing the user interface is fine in order to brainstorm what kind of information is needed. Still, start building the model first with your classes for the model, and then start building the actual application where you have the user interface interacting with your data. As soon as we work with client and server, it does not make any sense to build it like we did in the old ways, when we had like a Delphi form, drop components, and build everything on the form, maybe have one or two data modules. That approach will not work out in the end with a scenario like this. It's just plain and simple. If you think you can build the user interface, then start building the web service at the same time, it will end up in chaos. Because sooner or later you will recognize, which information do I need to pass from the client to the server? How does the server need to provide the data? And then it all starts to crumble, and you will need significantly longer compared to the time if you had planned your model accordingly. Now that I've talked so much about how important the data model is, let's actually look at the data model. First, the one that's located at the backend, because that is the data that is being transferred from the server to the client, whatever the client is. In this case, we're going to build a web client, but this could also be another VCL or FireMonkey application. I just want to point this out. Web services are not only used to connect to web applications, they have other use cases as well. You open up your application, or in this case, you can use this web service to provide directions to other applications that you might have. So the first step to create the backend is creating a TMS XData server application using File, New, Other. And then in the TMS XData category, you find the TMS XData VCL server. That's what I created. I made some slight modifications to the user interface, which I'll look at later. First, let's really, really focus on the data. Routes are between coordinates and contain a lot of coordinates where you're supposed to drive, right? So we need a basic coordinate, t-coordinate, latitude, longitude, both double values, and we need a list of those. Object list, generic object list, to have type safety on the list. And then each route, as we call it, contains multiple steps. And each step carries a distance, duration, and driving instructions. Turn left, turn right, onto this road, that road. Those are the driving instructions. The coordinates are also giving you the path that you're supposed to take on the map. So if you were to use a pen and connect the coordinates that are given inside of these lists or arrays, in this case we picked a list, then you would actually get the path of the route, and that's actually what we're going to do. Last but not least, we have the actual route, which consists of many steps. That's why we also create a list, t-steps, which is an object list of t-step. And each route has a total duration and a total distance, and of course, carries the steps. I also created a helper method to show that this can be added as well. You can say add step. This, instead of accessing steps from the outside, you can call add steps or add step. Apologies. That is something that the VCL does, for example. You have on a list box, you have list box items.add, but you also have add items on the actual list box, for example. Let's start with the outside object and go deeper, basically the other way around that I introduced the types. The root has to create and destroy this list. And as it's an object list, by default, all the items contained on the list are going to be freed automatically. So if you walk through the constructor, we have fsteps equals two steps create, and then in the destructor, we free everything. Very, very easy. In order to get the total duration and the total distance, we have to take the duration or the distance of each step and add it up. So let's look at get total duration, for example. We initialize with zero, and then we iterate all the steps and add them to the result. So total duration and total distance, really, really straightforward, but you might think it's kind of interesting that we don't have like a field for that. Instead, we have a read-only property, which by default, by the way, will not be serialized by XData. So we do the same thing on the client again in our class to get the total duration and total distance. We add them based on the list. The steps are a little bit more interesting. We have the coordinates, which is a list of coordinates. Again, in the constructor, we create this list, and in the destructor, we free this list. The distance and duration, pretty straightforward. Integers, by the way. Why integers? So the distance is given in meters. For all my American friends, that's the unit that they use everywhere else on the planet, but in the United States, that's the metric unit for distance. I'm exaggerating and kidding, of course, that every American I've met so far knows that what meters are, that is a unit of distance. The thing that makes this easy is if you have a distance in meters, you can divide by 1,000 and you have kilometers. And why Google chose the metric system, I don't know. I think in the API, you can also ask for imperial system measurements, meaning it would be miles and instead of kilometer, instead of meters or feet, most likely. I don't know. But this is all metric, and duration is given in seconds, not minutes. I made that mistake before. It gives funny results. So if you were to provide this in the United States only, you would probably create a second property, distance in miles or whatever, to do the conversion from the metric system to there. You could do that as well. I stay with the values as they are given by Google in metric kilometers. There's one more interesting aspect here, which is the procedure assign from. And this procedure allows us to easily assign the data that we get from the Google service to this step. So the Google service will return a list of data type TTMS FNC directions step, each step of the route. So with assign from, I can easily transfer the values from the TMS FNC map specific data type over to my data type. Again, I don't use the TMS FNC specific type because there's so much more information in the data type. If you look at it, for example, a directions step invoke code completion, all these I don't need. And also pointer is not really a data type or data object. It's nothing you can really serialize with TMS XData. So that is not possible. So instead we have our own clean type tstep, and the coordinate, there is really nothing to look at. The coordinate is just latitude, longitude. On the client, we do a little bit more with the coordinate in order to be able to add them to the map quickly, because in addition to this kind of class type, TMS FNC Maps also has a record type. To be able to convert this coordinate into a record is something that we will add on the client side to the data model. And that is something that I would like to emphasize right away. The data model on the client is written for the client specifically. So it doesn't have to match. You don't have to use the same classes, the same types on the server as on your client. And you will say like, well, that's probably bad design. You know, you just gave us a long explanation that the model should be thought through. So why would you have a different model on the server and on the client. Well, for example, your classes on the server could contain custom attributes for serialization, for example. Let's take the Neon serializer, for example. Imagine you do not use TMS XData and produce your JSON with a different serialization mechanism, and then your classes need additional information how to serialize that class. That will not compile in TMS Web Core because the classes that you might use or the custom attributes that you might reference, those units might not be available or most likely definitely are not available for Neon for TMS Web Core. So you would start writing defines. You know, you would say, okay, only add this code when we are working with the TMS VCL server project. And if we're working with the client project, then do not use this kind of code. And that becomes messy quite quickly. So I've become more looking into if I want to write convenience classes or convenience methods, I should say, for my classes, I make changes to the model classes that are client specific. So, and also you might, if you have a server method that returns a certain amount of data in JSON, you might not want to consume all that information on the client. Because usually you write a server having all or the most possible use cases in mind. And let's assume you write an iPhone widget, for example, and you only are interested in the total duration and in the total distance that you want to show on the home screen of the iPhone. Then you could argue, well, then write a separate endpoint that just returns these two numbers. Yes, but if you already retrieve the information with all the direction information, adding then a separate class to have more or less just these two numbers, and then also to have a different endpoint for that, it might be more straightforward to use a different data model on the client and import the or read the data from the server and incorporate it into the client model. So if we look at the client, the web application, on the service types, it looks very, very similar. We have the coordinate, we have the step, but for example, for the step, we no longer have the transfer assigned to method because we don't need it on the client. We don't need to transfer FNC map specific direction classes to a step. We don't have that here. On the other hand, we need a coordinate record array to quickly be able to draw a step on the map. So I provide that instead. And the same goes for the route. Same here, total duration, total distance, but I also provide the coordinate for the origin and a coordinate for the destination of the route. So I can quickly add markers for the origin and for the destination to the map. So this is what I mean. It is still, if you were to look at the class model of your overall data model, that has nothing to do with it. That's still the same. This is a specific model that you need for your application in this case. So instead of using one file and trying to build it in a way that you can use it for the server and the client, I opted to build two. Obviously, we can have different opinions on the subject, but this is how I approach this to have the best model for the client and the best model for the server. That's how I look at these things.